As a brand, I think 2019, with all the adversities that is going on, I think we still have been able to sustain better because of the wide range of products that we are having. When I say wide range of products, we are not just restricting ourselves to the conventional motherboard and graphic card business. It's been predominantly more diversified in terms of the overall portfolio that we carry. And here I'm just mentioning about the component space that we have. In the component space, we have close to 7 different product categories and 18 different product lines within those categories. If I say Q1, Q2, we had a small deficit, but I think Q3 will cover it up, and it is traditionally that way. Q1, Q2 or the first half of the year always has a single digit deficit which is there. But as I said in this beginning, the overall product portfolio that we have, that would, plus the Q3 festive season, would cover up the entire target base for the year, and we should hope to end it on a very positive note. For us, gaming has been a core of our overall business model. I think for the last 11 years, we already celebrated the ROG's 10th anniversary. So when no one was in this industry talking about gaming as a segment, we had been spearheading this for almost over a decade now. And now most of the entrants are there. But now what we have gone further is, not just in the conventional motherboard or graphic card, but our routers are gaming routers. Our keyboard mice are suited to that. We have power supplies designed for gamers. We have chassis designed for gamers. Not just restricting to the space, even in the system business, we have notebook that is for gaming. We even have launched our phone that is for gaming. So looking at this sphere, I think that's how a brand should target or look at the audience in the gaming community. In the esports space, we have own gaming team. A year back, we hosted the world's, India's most top-prized gaming competition. So that is how we keep encouraging the esports, not just participating through events, but even through our hardware. To be honest, at this moment, partners have absolutely no choice rather than not moving into that space. Earlier, there was specialized. Now, most of the products that are offered are provided in different range categories. So the channel partners, which used to feel it is not in their purview to sell a very high-end product, they also have an entry-level SKU. So for a gaming user, earlier gaming machines used to come like 50,000, 60,000. Now you can build a gaming machine even at a 30,000. So the range is increased. So the channel partners, to be honest, have more to win in this scenario when the revenues are dropping, when the moment they diversify, not just from motherboard or graphic card. Now they can sell the gaming routers. They have gaming accessories. So the entire ecosystem is looking at it. Not far from now, we also will have our gaming chairs. Think about a hardware brand bringing a gaming chair in this industry. So you can see the kind of potential that is there. And everything, whatever opportunity is there, we want to grab it with both hands. Traditional partners are the core to this business. It is, it's not that from the advent of online space, component business has shifted to online. No, most of the component business still depends and relies on all the system integrators, the value-added resellers, the dealer network. Even for distribution, if you look at it, our distribution still is the conventional old distribution pattern. It is not that the brand is importing it now. So we still go by the own conventional. We have close to almost 280 partners active in the entire business portfolio. So that's how in a country which has 28 states, so we have almost 280 partners, that means 10 in each, and those depends on each business unit. I would be happy to say this, the RMA numbers have reduced drastically over the years, and that is because of the kind of build that quality that we have. Plus, the TAT time is reduced. Earlier it used to be 10 days, 15 days. Now 90% of the TAT is less than 5 days. So that is the kind of service because the 5 days is basically the transit time, not and the repair at times. So that is what we keep looking out for. So the premium customers who have bought a motherboard, say 50,000, we ensure that he can get it on time. The Sometimes the technical issues are there, which he understands differently. Probably it's not the board issue, but probably it's a memory or a other device compatibility issue. So that would take a little bit more time to understand, but almost 90% of our cases are less than 5 days. And we are trying to improve, to narrow down. We are trying to create more regional hubs so that this 5 days also can be converted to 3 days. From the product focus point of view, I would still mention motherboard graphic card remains the core focus. So it is the legacy which we will keep maintaining and growing it. But the new addition in product lines that we are focusing overall as a brand, one is in the server business category, one is the wireless, and the other is LCD. It's not on the sequence of it. These are the three products that we focus aggressively for the coming years. Actually, we were not looking at this business portfolio for the last probably 3-4 years. But from the last 2 years, this business shows huge potential. And I'm not talking about the large enterprise. The small and the mid-sized enterprise is giving me businesses which is, I would say, at times the demand is more than what we can supply. And that is huge, and that is growing on a very fast pace. And currently we are just targeting at about 5 or 6 locations in the nation. So may it be the server farms, may it be the enterprise coming in single or 10 units. So that demand is too huge. ASUS is not a new brand in this country. There has been a legacy if you go from the distribution or the channel partners. They have been associated with us for a long, long period. That itself is a testimonial to the kind of service, the kind of products that we offer, the kind of margin that we are there. We don't look for a short-term gain. When there is an opportunity in the online space, we still encourage our partners to be one of the partners in the marketplace. So we didn't go directly to them. We used the channel partner, motivated them, trained them. Even now the training is still on to train the channel partners, their counter sales guys on how to better the sales. So my message to my partners across and the new partners who wants to enroll, ASUS still remains in the channel centric business, in the product which will be more profitable to them. In the era of where the revenue is dipping, profitability has to increase. So being associated with ASUS, you get a very wide range of products, plus you can ensure your profitability is not dipping. That is what ASUS would want to join hand with you to keep progressing over the next few years.
Thank you for watching this video. Also, please subscribe our page and like us on social media to help us in reaching more people. Till we come up with our next video, goodbye and take care.